officially just 1 week away from Halloween.
Yes.
Believe it. And today, Ken Page and Orly are here to help us cross off another item off our fall harvest bucket list, and that item is carved pumpkins, and that's exactly what we all did.
Yes.
And we are starting with you, Paigey.
Okay. Well, it's no secret to everybody at home and here that I love kitty cats.
Yes.
So I always try to, every year, I either dress up as a cat or I dress my cats up. No.
They come dressed.
Or both.
Yeah. If you ever try to dress a cat, you know it doesn't go well.
Okay.
So I'm going to make a little kitty. So the first thing, I want to start with like an oblong pumpkin. These are real pumpkins. And then I just cut off the stem and added a tiny little nightlight there, battery operated.
Adorable.
Okay, and so then I took another pumpkin. I'm gonna start this way. This is how I started. I took the top off, but that's actually gonna be the bottom side. So we turn them over once we clean them out, did some eyes, and did a little fabric tack and craft foam for the ears.
Oh, is that what that is? I was gonna ask you.
Yes.
Okay, great.
So, and then you just set it right on top. You wanna make sure that this is big enough, a big enough diameter that it's going to fit over the other pumpkin.
Wow.
So yes, we're not accentuating the neck here.
No.
And then before I put the paws on, I want to show you, the little tail. This is a gourd.
Gosh.
Can you see him?
It's
He's
a
so
gourd.
Cute. It's a gourd. Yes, a real gourd. And I just put a little toothpick in there, and that's all in the kitty cat. Tail can wag.
That's adorable.
Goodness,
okay,
that's
so then we're gonna move to the front.
I love how the orange of the pumpkin gives him like actual orange cat eyes.
I know, I know. Okay, so then these are his little feet, and I'm just gonna take regular, like a bigger pumpkin for the back, a smaller pumpkin for the front.
Like his real feet.
And there you go.
That's
cute, Paige.
That's a good kitty.
Really cute. Should we check it out at night? It looks cute now, but. Let's see it at night. Let's see it glow. Do we have a shot of that?
Check me out.
Become spooky cat.
Okay.
Awesome.
All right. Pretty awesome. You got to follow that, Orly.
Cool.
What do you got? What do you got?
My family is obsessed with baseball.
Really?
Obsessed. Mm. My son is now playing baseball. We all go. Blake cheers him on. There he is. He's obsessed with it. And so as a family, now everyone's really excited. It's obviously the World Series.
Right.
Obviously.
LA Dodgers.
Obviously.
Might be in the World Series.
They may or may not.
They may or may not. So I wanted to do a baseball pumpkin, something I thought my kids would get a real kick out of. So this is just this is also a real pumpkin, and we painted the entire thing white.
That's pretty cool.
So that's what we start
so cute.
Fully white. Next, you just want to draw your pattern. So you can start off with a pencil to create yourself a nice guide, and then go over it with a Sharpie. So once you've created kind of the stitches and the lines all along that are going to create our shape, now we're going to go in and do each of these stitches. Now I think this is actually really cool. I'm going to go on the bottom here, and the way that we're going to do this is about, you want to separate them, you know, space them out about an inch or so, inch and a half apart. So I'm going to do my next middle one, and this is just basically an awl that we're going to go in, create an opening. Now do the same thing right here, another inch apart. That way you stay in that consistent V shape. So you're going to create three of those little.
You are really giving it your all.
This is cool.
Man, you are the worst. Okay. So now take the center of this. You just cut a little piece, and we're going to use
that's
it.
That's tricky.
It's not stitched.
I was trying to figure out how did she get in? That's amazing.
You just jam it in.
We're going to push it in. You can cut off the excess once you get a nice amount in there.
Once you feel like it's secured.
Take it and cut it. And each one of these is an individual stitch, so you don't have to open up the pumpkin.
So it lasts a little longer, too, doesn't
it? When I looked at it, I thought you would actually cut the whole pumpkin.
And
that's what I thought.
I did.
Listen, if I could get some extra credit, I'll tell you that I did that.
Okay.
That is
I think this deserves extra credit.
Well done. And by the way, he's going to love this.
He's going to freak out. He's going to be amazing.
So now,
speaking of amazing,
well, you know, I love me a miniature. And why should miniatures be reserved?
You okay? Go ahead.
I see this.
So I did a lovely little miniature haunted house scene inside the pumpkin. How gorgeous.
Why do you always do the extra credit, Ken?
He started working on it in
September. I'm still the little chubby kid who has to get approval from his teacher. That's where it is.
Amazing.
So I started with an artificial pumpkin.
But his isn't real.
It's not real pumpkin.
Oh, yeah.
I drew on the front. If you need to find one, you can print one out. And then I just use a utility knife, simple utility knife to cut that.
Simple.
Then for the inside, the base is actually just the top of a styrofoam ball. And then the house, you can either use a pre-built house or I made this one. And all it is, it's paper. It's a little tin, just paper. And then painted the back in blue, dark blue and white on top. And then for the trees, just little branches right here. And you just stick them straight into that foam.
Are those real branches?
Real branches, a little bit of like polyfill for like the fog and mist, very woo. And then in the back, I'm gonna flip it over here.
Yeah, you got to
love these little battery
operated. Well, then we gotta check it out at night too.
Poke holes, slip it through, and turn it on.
Because it's gonna glow up, isn't it?
Let's check. There you go.
Wow. So cute.
Oh, my God.
That is
got the little flickering lights on the inside.
I think it's safe to say that our family members don't mess around when it comes to Halloween. Well done, everybody. Now, stick around, because Debbie and I are showing you our pumpkin creations. And I just like to say mine's a pretty big deal. Here's a big deal. Welcome back, everyone. Paige, Ken, and Orly showed off some really fun creative pumpkins. But now it's time for Debbie and I to do a little showing off. Right, Deb?
Yeah, I mean, I feel, I made mine for Alexandra.
Aww, listen.
It's so cute.
I mean, it's certainly not.
You do not have to downplay this.
I really like it. So all I did was get a synthetic pumpkin, and I used a carving tool and cut a hole in here. Then just use some fabric tack and just glued down some lace. I got some rhinestone chains and some just plastic accoutrement like this.
It is adorable.
And the reason I think is because Alexandra is a ballerina and she's obsessed with ballet right now. And you don't even ruin the doll. You just stick the doll
right in there. You just stick the doll in, and that's part of the ball gown.
Color of the doll's dress, you paint the pumkin the same color, so it looks like the gown.
Debbie, come on.
She's so cute. She's going to love this.
I can't believe
you downplayed this yet, so she's really going to love it.
I love it. Yay.
What about yours, too?
What is going on over
here? Oh, you mean my little pumpkin? What are you talking about? Listen, here's the thing.
Wow.
I get extra bonus points, A, because mine's colossal, but B, because I kept it in the original color orange. I stuck with the basics. Ken, I used some of the tools that you gave me in your pumpkin carving segment. Do you remember?
Oh, good.
And I also got a little help because clearly I needed some.
And then you had a mirror, so you got your likeness exact?
I mean, look at the two of us. Wait, side by side.
Can't tell the difference.